Dear students, today I am explaining the next bit from your topic gaseous state. That is the derivation of kinetic gas equation. So look towards the next PPT. Now we have to derive the kinetic gas equation. That is the derivation of kinetic gas equation. Today we have to derive the equation PV is equal to PV is equal to 1/3 mu². This is a kinetic gas equation which we have to derive. To derive the kinetic gas equation, we are considering here a cubic box. The dimensions of the box are in this way. The length of each side of the box is L centimeter. Means the length of the box is L centimeter. Breadth is also L centimeter and height is also L centimeter. Means the every side having a length L centimeter. Then the total number of gas molecules which are enclosed in this cubic vessel, that are N molecules. The mass of the one molecule is considered as small m, and the velocity of a molecule is considered here as v. In this way, by consider a certain mass of a gas enclosed in a cubic box at a fixed temperature. At a fixed temperature, we are considering a gas is enclosed in a cubic vessel. That cubic box or the vessel having length side, every side L centimeter length, number of molecules enclosed are the n, mass of every molecule is small m, and velocity associated with the every molecule is v. We have to derive the kinetic gas equation. That kinetic gas equation is PV is equal to 1/3 mu². In this case, this is our x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is z-axis. It may be velocity components may be represented here in this way: vx along the x-axis, vy along the y-axis, and vz is a velocity component along the z-axis. In the second cubic box, it is shown here that the distance between the two faces, face A and face B, is L centimeter. Then whenever the molecule is approaching towards the face A, then the velocity component is Vx. Being it is moving along the x-axis, the velocity component is Vx. After colliding with the face A, that gas molecule is bouncing back or coming back with the velocity component minus Vx. So keep it in your mind. Then we have to go towards the next step. First step which we have to take under consideration is the resolution of velocity of a single molecule along the x, y and z axis. Velocity is a vector quantity. and can be resolved into the components Vx, Vy and Vz along x, y and z axis. Therefore, we can write the equation V square is equal to Vx square plus Vy square plus Vz square. In this way, we could resolve the velocity of a single molecule along the three axes, that is the x, y and z. Then in the second step, we have to find out the collisions, number of collisions with the phase A, number of collisions per second on phase A due to one molecule. In this case, this molecule, a single molecule which we have taken under consideration, that molecule is moving along the x axis in this way. Whenever it is approaching towards the phase A in this way, whenever gas molecule is approaching towards the phase A, then whatever the velocity component that is considered here as a Vx, that is the plus Vx, being it is approaching towards the phase A. After colliding with the phase A, that molecule is bounced back in this way, and whenever it is returning back, at that time the velocity component is minus Vx. In this way, we have to find out the number of collisions of molecule which is approaching towards the phase A and coming back, colliding the wall B, and once again it is bouncing back, and once after traveling the distance L centimeter, once again it is colliding with the phase A and going on, and it is going on for the further steps also. Means how many collisions that single molecule is doing on the phase A per second, that we have to find out. So number of collisions per second on phase A due to a single molecule, one molecule. Consider a molecule is moving along x axis, that molecule is moving along the x axis in this way. This is a box which we are considering here. Whenever gas molecule is colliding with the wall of the container, it is bouncing back . This is the cubic box which I am sketching here. This is the phase A. This is the phase B. Whenever gas molecule is approaching towards the phase A, then its velocity component is V to the base X. Whenever the gas molecule is returning back after collision, its velocity component is minus Vx. I am writing the Vx properly after erasing it. See carefully. okay. Consider a molecule is moving along x-axis. This is a molecule which is moving along the x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is the z-axis. Whenever gas molecule is moving along the x-axis, then it strikes the face A with velocity vx and rebound with velocity minus vx. Whenever a molecule is approaching towards the face A along the x-axis, then velocity component is plus vx before the collision. But after the collision, what happens? It rebound back with the velocity component minus vx. The distance between the face A and B is L centimeter. Whatever the distance between that two faces, that is the L centimeter. This distance is L centimeter. Time between the two collisions for of face A is equal to A is equal to 2L upon Vx second. What much time is required to do the collision with the face A? That time is given by the 2L upon Vx. Time between the two collisions of face A is equal to 2L upon Vx second. This much time is required for the collision. Then the number of collisions per second is equal to A is equal to Vx upon 2L. This is the reciprocal. Number of collisions per second on face A is given by the Vx upon 2L. Means in this case, A is equal to Vx upon 2L are the number of collisions of a single molecule on face A per second. This is the number of collisions of a single molecule per second on face A. Then we have to see the next step. Total change of momentum on all faces of box due to one molecule only. In the cubic box, there are six faces. We have seen the collision on face A, number of collisions of a single molecule per second on face A. Here that it is a face B. Each impact of the molecule on face A causes a change of momentum. Change of momentum is nothing but the product of mass into velocity. Change of momentum or momentum before the impact will be the plus mvx. Momentum of a molecule after impact or after collision with the face A, that will be minus mvx. Momentum after the impact, that will be minus mvx. The change in momentum will be given as momentum before the impact minus momentum after impact, that is mvx minus in bracket minus mvx. Minus into minus, it will become the plus 1 plus mvx plus mvx, that will be 2 mvx. But the number of collisions per second on face A due to one molecule is vx upon 2l, which we have derived in the first equation. In the second step, these are the number of collisions of a single molecule on face A per second. This is the total change of momentum of a single molecule, a change in momentum of a single molecule on the face A only. Then total change of momentum per second on face A due to one molecule is equal to 2mvx into vx upon 2l is equal to mvx square upon l. 2 will be cancelled here. This 2 and this 2 will be cancelled, and remaining is mv x square x vx into vx vx square mv x square upon l. Means to find out the total momentum of the single molecule per second on phase A is calculated by multiplying the number of collisions per second to the momentum to mvx, and finally we get the total change of momentum per second on phase A due to one molecule is mv x square upon l. Then the change of momentum on both the opposite faces, that is A and B, will be doubled, that is 2mv x square upon l. This is the change in momentum of a single molecule on both the faces, that is the phase A and phase B, opposite faces. Similarly, the change of momentum along the y axis and along the z axis will be 2mv y square upon l into 2mvz square upon l. This is the change in momentum for the single molecule on both the faces along the x-axis. This is along the x-axis. In the same method, change in momentum on both the faces along the y-axis will be 2mvy square upon l. Along the z-axis, it will be 2mvz square upon l. In this way, up to this point, we have calculated the change in momentum of a single molecule along the opposite faces, along x-axis, along y-axis, and along z-axis. Now the total change of momentum, or the overall change of momentum per second on all faces due to a single molecule only, to find out that, we have to add all these change in momentum. That is 2mvx square upon l plus 2mvy square upon l plus 2mvz square upon l. In this way, we have to find out the overall change of momentum per second. We have added here all the terms in this way. 2mvx square upon l plus 2mvy square upon l plus 2mvz square upon l. In this case, 2m and 2m is present in every term. So we are taking the common. Upon l is here. Here is also there is l to the denominator. In this case also there is a l in the denominator. So we are taking the l also common. The remaining terms are vx square plus vy square plus vz square will be taken into the bracket in this way. 2m upon l into vx square plus vy square plus vz square will be remain in the bracket. But vx square plus vy square plus vz square is equal to 1, is equal to v square as per the first step. That is the resolution of velocity. So we could write the equation, overall change of momentum per second on all the faces of the box due to one molecule, that is 2mv square upon l. This is the overall change of momentum per second on all the faces of the box due to the single molecule only. Then in the next step, we have to find out the total change of momentum due to impact of all the molecules on all faces. Up to this point, we have calculated only the total change of momentum of a single molecule on all faces. Now we have to find out the total change of momentum due to impacts of all the molecules on all faces. In this case, we have supposed there are n molecules in the box, each of which moving with the different velocities, as like the v1, v2 and v3 and so on. Total change of momentum due to impacts of all the molecules on all faces of the box may be written in this way. 2m upon l into bracket v1 square plus V2 square plus V3 square plus plus in this way dash dash. In this way, we could write the equation for the total change of momentum due to impacts of all the molecules on all the face of the box. Multiplying this equation, multiplying and dividing this equation by the n, we have 2mn upon L in bracket V1 square upon plus V2 square plus V3 square plus 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 dash dash upon n is equal to 2m n u square upon L. Means instead of this term, we have used here the u square. U square is the mean square velocity. Then we have to find out the derivation of, we have to find out the kinetic gas equation, or we have to calculate the pressure from the change of momentum. Next step, derivation of kinetic gas equation, that is the calculation of pressure from change of momentum. Force may be defined as the change in momentum per second. What is mean by force? Force is nothing but the change in momentum per second. That change in momentum per second is nothing but the force. So we can write the change in momentum per second is equal to force is equal to mn u square upon L. This is the change in momentum, that is total change in momentum of all molecules on all the faces of the box. That is 2mn u square upon L. This is the total change in momentum. But total change in momentum is nothing but the force. So we can write the force is equal to 2mn u square upon L. But pressure is equal to, but pressure is equal to force upon area. In this case, we have to consider the total force upon total area. The total force is the total momentum, total change in momentum per second for all the molecules on all the faces. That will be 2mn u square upon L, that is the force, divided by total area. We are considering here a cube. So this cube having the six faces, area of the total area of the cube we have to calculate. We are considering the cube to this cube. There are six faces. One, two, three, 4, front 5 and back 6. In this way, there are 6 faces. In this case, every side is of L centimeter. So, it is a square. The area will be the L square of a single, for the single face. Being there are 6 faces, the total area of the cubic box, faces of the cubic box, is 6L square. So we have to use the equation pressure equal to total force upon total area. Total force is nothing but a total change in momentum per second of by the all molecules on all faces, that is a 2mn u square upon L. We are using here the total force in this way. P is equal to pressure, P is equal to total force into 1 upon total area. Total area for the cubic box which having length of every side is L centimeter, that is the 6L square will be the टोटल एरिया. फ्रॉम दिस टू वन जा टू एंड टू थ्री जा सिक्स, वन बाय थ्री दिस वन, रिमेनिंग टर्म्स आर एम एन यू स्क्वेयर, एम एन यू स्क्वेयर अपॉन एल, दिस एल एंड दिस एल स्क्वेयर फॉर्मिंग द एल क्यूब. इन दिस वे पी इज इक्वल टू वन बाय थ्री एम एन यू स्क्वेयर अपॉन एल क्यूब विल बी द इक्वेशन. देन वी हैव टू सी द नेक्स्ट स्टेप. सिंस एल क्यूब इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द क्यूब फी, वी हैव इंस्टेड ऑफ एल क्यूब वी कुड यूज द वी. बींग द एल क्यूब इज द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द क्यूब, लेंथ इंटू ब्रेथ इंटू हाइट, एल इंटू एल इंटू एल, दैट विल बी एल क्यूब. Therefore, P is equal to 1 by 3 mn u square upon V. V is coming instead of the L cube. Then rearranging this equation, this V goes towards the left side of the equation, towards the numerator. It will forming the PV. PV is equal to 1 by 3 mn u square. This is the kinetic gas equation. In this way, we have derived the kinetic gas equation. In the first step, we have considered the cube with these dimensions, L centimeter length, N number of molecules, having the mass M for a single molecule, velocity is V, and all these considerations. In the next step, we have decided the velocity, resolution of velocity of a single molecule on the x and y and z axis in this way. Then number of collisions per second on phase A due to one molecule will be calculated as A is equal to Vx square upon 2L. This is the number of collisions per second on phase A. Then total change of momentum on all faces of the box due to one molecule only, that will be calculated, and that value is 2mvx square upon L. That is the total change of momentum, this is change in momentum of a this one, total change of momentum of a single molecule on a single phase, that is the phase A, is mv per second, that is mvx square upon L. For two phases, phase A and phase B, which are the opposite to each other, the change in momentum will be 2mvx square upon L. This is the change in momentum along the x axis only. Similarly, for the y axis and z axis, it will be 2mvy square upon L and 2mvz square upon L. By adding all these three, we are getting the overall change of momentum per second on all the phases due to one molecule only, that is 2mv square upon L. This is the overall change of momentum of a single molecule whenever it is colliding with the all faces of the molecule, all faces of the cubic box. This is the overall change of momentum per second on all faces of the box. This is for the single molecule only. Then for n number of molecules, it will be 2m upon L total change of momentum due to impact of all the molecules on all faces of the box. That will be calculated in this way, and the finally it is 2mn u square upon L, where u is the mean square velocity. Then by the known value of the total change of momentum of all the molecules on all faces, we have derived the pressure P in this way. But during this, we have considered that change in momentum per second is nothing but the force. That is equal to the right equation. Force is equal to 2 mn u square upon L. This value of the force is used in this equation, pressure is equal to total force upon total area. By putting the value of force and area, we have derived the equation in this way, where L cube is nothing but the volume. So we have replaced the L cube by the V, and the final equation is PV is equal to 1 by 3 mn u square. This is the kinetic gas equation. In this way, we have derived the kinetic gas equation. Thank you for watching the video. We will see the next part in the next video. Thank you.